Minister with responsibility for physical planning, Honorable Harold Stanislas, has reiterated government's commitment to guarding the right of citizens to access all beaches on the island. The assurance comes amid public concern regarding the proposed Cabot St. Lucia development at Capay Estate. The Cabinet of Ministers has approved a lease of the Queen's Chain adjacent to the development site for 75 years. However, Honorable Stanislas says the approval does not bar St. Lucians from accessing the Casabar Beach.
The Cabinet conclusion clearly states that Cabot development had a surplus on the parcels of land. It was already in existence. Those leases were issued to Capay Estate Limited in 1973 for 75 years. There is a 28-year grace period and time remaining on those leases, and basically the Cabinet conclusion is an extension of those leases to another 75 years. Secret Beach, Casabar Beach, Donkey Beach, none of those beaches will list to Cabot development. So in essence, the beaches remain public. In fact, all the beaches on the island remain public, so that citizens have unlimited access to the beaches. There should not be any impediments of our citizens for the use of our beaches for recreational purposes.
The Physical Planning Minister says the government is aware and sensitive to the concerns surrounding the continued operation of Marjorie's Restaurant, which has been a staple at the Casabar Beach for more than 20 years. Marjorie Lambert, in 2001, was issued a lease for 5 years for the block and parcel that her establishment is situated. Ms. Lambert currently holds a one-year lease.
We are not going to infringe on the rights of Ms. Marjorie or prevent Ms. Marjorie from earning a living, which she has been doing so for about 20 years or more in this particular area. There will be discussions with Ms. Marjorie and the developers, and also with the parliamentary representative, Honorable Motut, and the Department of Physical Planning, on the way forward. But we are going to do everything within our powers to work with the developer, with Ms. Marjorie, and all stakeholders who currently have establishments on the beach at Casabar. But I want to reinstate again, the beach is public. There is going to be unrestricted access to the Casabar Beach, to Donkey Beach, to Secret Beach by the citizens of St. Lucia.
Leasing of the Queen's Chain, Minister Stanislas says, has been practiced for decades.
You have a lease in 2000 there between the state and the business for the Queen's Chain. You have emphyteutic leases for 75 years, 99 years. You know, in 2005 we had leases. In 2004, we had leases of the Queen's Chain. 2006, we had leases of the Queen's Chain. I could go on to this other section right there. Those other leases. We had leases in 2008, emphyteutic leases of the Queen's Chain. We had leases in 2011, 99-year emphyteutic leases, two hotels, two developers. We had emphyteutic leases issued in 2008 again, in 2009, 2014. So this is not something new. This is not a new practice, it's not a new policy. This has been a policy, an initiative, a practice of governments since the 1970s of leasing of the Queen's Chain to developers, to persons who own property adjacent to the Queen's Chain. Again, all beaches are public. There is unrestricted access to the beaches, either by foot or vehicular access. There are certain properties where you do not have vehicular right of way on the map sheet or the land registry, so persons usually access those beaches by foot. There are beaches where there is unrestricted vehicular access. If you come in by sea, you could access any beach on the island for recreational use.
Cabot St. Lucia has submitted a master plan to the Department of Physical Planning. Honorable Stanislas says the department is processing the proposals in phases. Upon final approval, the minister stressed there will be no restricted access to the Casabar Beach.